Hello everyone, this is the first part in my second Civilization 5, I guess, Let's Play video. The first one I ended up playing, who was it, the Koreans. And I played it through and I actually got a diplomatic victory. This time, I don't know what I'm going to get, but I'll start out showing the mods that I'm going to use. This is a slightly different list of mods than I used last time. So, the unlimited experience from Barbarians, that one I used last time as well. From playing a number of games with this mod in place, I haven't found that it unbalances the game particularly. You don't end up with too many units wandering around getting massive promotions out the wazoo. It does mean that you're likely to get a unit or two that are promoted to the max, but it doesn't generally give you a particularly unsurmountable edge. And also because, the other players also get the same bonus. I use the Lake Victoria fix because Lake Victoria is, get this, a lake, and this actually makes it behave like one. It makes it behave like fresh water, and it makes it so you can actually see across it, which you ought to be able to. It's water, after all. I use the less warmonger hate one, and that's because the warmongering penalties are ridiculously stiff, and in the regular base game. You get a situation in the base game where if you have to wipe somebody out, one of the particularly nasty warmongering civs attacks you, and the only way that you can get them to leave you alone is to wipe them out, well, you'll end up with a penalty that lasts the entire freaking game. And all the other civs will hate you for the rest of the game, unless they happen to like warmongers. And so you can't actually wage a defensive war at all. If you have to take out massive numbers of the guy's cities just to get him to leave you alone, to take out his war apparatus, well, it means you're going to be pretty much at war for the rest of the game. So, this mod actually makes that a little more sensible. It doesn't mean you don't get a warmongering penalty, but you know, taking one, like wiping out one civilization doesn't give you a permanent, massive black mark against everybody. The pontoon bridge one is really just allowing the pontoon bridge from a particular scenario to be available in the regular game. It doesn't really convey a lot of particularly big benefits, but you know, it's kind of neat. And you know, to build one, you have to actually burn a settler, or not a settler, a worker. So you're not going to be building them everywhere. And there are some limitations as well. Now, I also chose to use the Ancient Ruins Choice Promotion mod, which means you get to choose which bonus you get from an ancient ruin. Now, that doesn't mean you get to choose from every possible bonus and every possible ruin. Now, let's be clear there. But it means that you can avoid getting, 10 times in a row just finding out where all the nearby barbarians are, you know, that sort of thing. And you can choose a bonus that's actually useful. I thought about using the promotion allowing units to cross mountains, and then I thought, you know, mountains being a barrier, it adds a challenge to the game. Maybe I'll try that another time. I thought about reforestation as well, you know, to plant forests. But I thought, what do I need to plant forests for? I just need to not chop them down, right? I used the mod that allows copper to be go in with the mint as well as silver and gold, which does make sense. So I did that. This is an old version of the pontoon bridge mod, which is what I was using previously. This poor tiles tweak mod basically makes snow and deserts and so on not totally useless. You would potentially be able to get some sort of support off of snow and desert tiles, potentially. And it also allows some worker improvements and so on. The reason I went for that is if you get a tundra start, you're pretty much hosed in the stock game. So there we go. This scout to explorer one gives you an upgrade for scouts to an explorer unit, which is nice in the later game if you have to actually explore any territory, or you need somebody to park somewhere to observe things. And I always thought that starting with a settler and a warrior wasn't terribly useful. So I started playing with starting with a scout instead of a warrior. And this one's fair because the AIs get the scout as well. So it's not meaning I get a scout and they get a warrior, right? So I went with that because it just makes the game a little less tedious in early going. I'm also using this enhanced water tiles mod, and the reason I'm using that is in the stock game, water tiles are worthless unless they have a resource on them. I'm not overstating that either. Water tiles are worthless. If you have a city, say you're Polynesia or something, and you've got ocean starts, right? Or you got a city on the coast, which is not uncommon, then oftentimes half of the tiles in the city radius can't be improved to the point where they do anything but status quo maintenance for population. At best, you get 2 food out of the water tiles, and that's just useless. You can't grow your city from that. And all you can do is maintain a population. So basically, water tiles are so useless in the base game that coastal cities are worthless, almost. I thought about this workable mountains thing, but I tried it once or twice. It didn't give me a huge amount of benefit, near as I could tell. Anyway, we'll get on with the game starting here. Of course, we have to wait for the game to do its thing. Okay, so again, here's the list of mods. It's going to be a single-player game. I'll set up the game. I'm going to play a random civilization. But there's a couple of cases where I will, in fact, just restart the game if I draw it. I'm going to restart if I draw Venice for sure. I don't find it particularly matches my play style. I don't want to do a single city challenge. So anyway, we'll go into the advanced setup here. So I'm going to play a random. We're going to play on Pangaea. It's going to be a huge map at standard difficulty. I'm going to play a marathon pace game. I'm going to make the world 5 billion years old. The rainfall is going to be normal, and the sea level is going to be low. That will give maximum land area. And we'll use a standard resource layout. Now, I play with the quick combat and quick movement because it does speed up the game significantly, and I got bored ages ago watching the battle animations. But everything else will be pretty much default here. I'm going to turn off the time victory just in case we get a bad start and nobody looks like they're getting toward winning by the end of any victory condition by the end of 1500 turns. Because that's how long the marathon game lasts. Now, I won a diplomatic victory last time. Cultural is what I usually end up winning. I don't end up getting domination. On a huge map, domination is really quite difficult. And a science victory, I don't think I've ever managed one. I usually end up pulling a cultural victory first, or last time, diplomatic. The only reason I managed to pull a diplomatic victory last time around, I think, is because Venice and Austria were not in the game, so all 24 city-states were still there by the time the end game rolled around. I will leave these four victory conditions enabled. I'm just turning off the time one so that one of these happens instead of timing out at 1500 turns if the game happens to be slow. Okay, so that's my settings here. So I'll start the game. The real question is going to be, we got Byzantium. I don't think I've played Byzantium before. So that means we get an extra religious belief when we found a religion. So that'd be pretty nice. So I think we really want to rush a religion here. Now, one of the reasons the turns and setup is slow is because it's a huge map, and that takes quite a lot of resources here. Okay, what kind of a start have we got here? We got stone, we got crab, and whales. So we're actually pretty good there. We're within two tiles of a mountain. That'll be nice later. There's a nice wonder or two that need that. We have some desert tiles nearby. Which may or may not be helpful. Grassland. We have an oasis down here. This is forest along here. It looks like it's forest in here as well. So it doesn't look like I'm going to learn anything useful by sending my scout anywhere, but I'm going to head this way. Yeah, I'm not really going to learn anything particularly helpful this way, but I'll send the scout closer to the ruins here. So I'm going to actually settle at the starting location. We're on a river. This is actually a pretty good start. What's under the forest here? It's grassland. So production's not going to be that great here. So we'll probably end up... we've got a tundra up here. So we've got a... It looks like a northerly start. So we'll see how this goes. Anyway, I'm going to found the capital right here. So we have Constantinople. Okay, let's just open this up so we can, because I want to, rush a religion, I'm going to go for pottery so we get the, shrine. Now the first thing we're going to build, I'm going to build a monument because I want the culture as well. Right, and there's not much more we can do here. Let's take a look in here and see if there's any point in micromanaging the citizens. No, there really isn't. Okay, so we're really going to want to get to masonry so we can build quarries on our stone here. And because we have sea resources, we're going to want seafaring as well. Anyway, we'll let the other players actually start. That didn't take very long. Now the city-states are starting as well. Okay. What do we get here? What we're hoping for in one of these is studying the tribe's religion so that we get some faith points early on so we can get a pantheon. So culture or tech? If we go for culture, we can open piety right away and the shrine will be cheaper when it comes. Or we can go for a tech. I'm going to go for a tech here. And we got mining, so this is good. And we've got barbarians over here. Now, it might be worth picking off this barbarian just to advance the scout so we get the healing and so on. But let's just see what we can see over here. So we're not going to do too well here. It'll take a long time to pick this guy off. So let's just see if we can find more ruins in the area. Oftentimes there'll be a fair number of them around. And if we can find some more, we can get much more along here. And there's one. So that's good. So we'll open this up, and you see we've got a different setup here. If we use this one, we'll end up with an archer, and then the promotions we get will be related to the archer, but we'll still have the ignore terrain bit. Maps will just show us what's around. This can be useful if you have a city that has good production tiles around it. You can actually get things going, but I'm going to enhance culture this time. So now we're only 10 turns off of the first social policy. Ah, the barbarian came out here. Yeah, we'll attack him and see what happens. So we should get a promotion real soon now for our scout here. He's going to attack, I think. Oh, he went home. Well, I think we should let the scout heal a bit before we do anything. I think we'll go after him now to see what happens. Hey, so we're pretty close. We should get the upgrade real soon now. There we go. So we could go for an additional visibility range, or we can go for survivalism, which is healing, or we can do an insta-heal. I'm going to go for the survivalism. It means we're going to heal 15 points per turn instead of 10. And I think he's going to kill us this time. I shouldn't have attacked. Ooh, that is lucky. Like we're down to what, one hit point? Yeah, one hit point. That was lucky. Don't do that in your games. Anyway, I'll clear the encampment just for the gold, and so we don't have barbarians showing up there. And then let the guy heal. Seriously, you don't wander a unit around with one hit point. I suspect there's some ancient ruins over here as well. But I'm not wandering that scout around until he's healed. Okay, there's our social policy. Now, I said I wanted to rush a religion, so I'm going to open piety. I've actually found in the past few games I've played that opening piety right away is good. I'm thinking the Celts are in, and they got a forest start because normally you or somebody else managed to trip on a religious ruin. So I'm betting the Celts are in the game, and they're the ones that got that pantheon, which means that we're not going to get first religion either, in all likelihood. Which is annoying, but, you know, that's the way things go. Okay, so let's see what's over here. Oh, we found the Arabs. Okay. This is a lake. Oh, there's a ruin. I'm surprised the Arabs haven't found it. They probably went the other way in their scouting, because they would have known this mountain was here. Oh, look, Constantinople has grown. Okay. Okay, we'll study the tribe's religion. This is good. We got 50 faith. We need 45 for a pantheon, so that's enough. Good. 30 is the, what's necessary for first pantheon, for, and it goes up for each one after that. Oh, right. I need to take a look at what we've got here. Okay, culture from shrines could be good. Faith from tundra. Faith from desert. We have some desert tiles. That might be okay, actually. Faith from copper, iron, salt. Production in cities with 3+. That might be a good one to go with, actually. God King would be good if we were playing a one city challenge, but we're not. We don't have wine and incense kicking around. It doesn't look like we're going to have camps around our capital. Science from city connections, faith from natural wonders. We don't have gold and silver. Faster border growth could be useful. We don't have jungle tiles. We are on a river. That might be useful, potentially. Faith from quarries. This, I think, is what we want. Because we're going to have quarries for the stone there. So we'll go with that one. Almost certainly it's not the right one. What to go with here? We got 8 turns for pottery. I'll start on a worker. Okay. Keep on exploring here. I'm looking for ancient ruins. Now watch, there's one there. That looks like a pass, actually, where you can actually get through the mountains. Okay, there's the coast. So as I was saying, this city here doesn't have good production, so it's not an ideal start. Well, there's something up there. So we're going to have a bit of a slow start here. We're not going to get some of the nice early wonders. That's not the end of the world, though. Okay, there's pottery. So I'm going to keep this guy moving. Now I'm going to switch to a shrine, which will take 10 turns. Now, calendar gives us the possibility of Stonehenge. Now, if I go that way, it's 44 turns to get calendar. And then probably about 200 turns to build Stonehenge, so that won't be ideal. Whereas if I go for masonry, I'll be able to build quarries on the stone. And that'll get me the faith from the quarries. And I think that's going to be much more beneficial. Oh, there's a ruin. The Huns. Oh my. Oh, bugger! That was annoying. Yeah, that's the risk you take if you take too long to get out in areas. Other explorers will take the ruins from you. That was such a nasty one. I'm right beside it, and the guy gets it. I mean, you can't get that any closer to getting it than that. Okay, that was a shrine. We'll go back to the worker. So now we're generating one faith per turn, so that's better than nothing. We need 600 faith to get a great profit now. I suspect I'm not going to get my favorite beliefs, which are pagodas and mosques. That doesn't necessarily mean I'm going to get a bad religion. There are, after all, other ones that are reasonably good as well. A fair bit of open land here, actually. Maybe at some point I'll actually load up a game with 22 civs on a huge map instead of the usual 12. That's quite a different ball game because you're going to have border competition early on in that. Okay, Portugal. Oh, policy. This policy doubles the faith I'm generating from shrines, so that's where I'll go next. So I suspect we're not going to get the first religion. It's possible we might, but I suspect we won't. I'm just going to take a look. Religion overview. World religions. No. Beliefs. Yeah, we haven't met the people that took that one. Okay. Ooh, I have an enemy at Constantinople. Ah, it's a barbarian. Since nothing's improved, it doesn't make all that much difference what the barbarian does. That doesn't mean we should let the barbarian maraud around, of course. So I'm going to get the worker before I get masonry. That could be annoying. So you notice I'm going from hill to hill here. Right. And that's simply because hills give a larger visibility, distance. It looks like I'm not going to be finding a lot of ancient ruins here, so I'm thinking it might be worth... and there I go. I'm saying I'm not going to find them, and then there is one. Right. Another hit on that guy, and he should die. I want to actually... Oh, there's a city-state. I haven't seen one of those either. Okay, that one's gone. Good. I think it'd be worth possibly opening honor next. Okay. Ah, we're going to discover a great prophet. That gets us much closer to our religion. That's definitely worth doing. I'm going to go meet the city-state after that. And we're the first people to meet, Riga, whatever it is. This one's hostile. Makes it harder to make friends. Anyway. Right. Ooh, a natural wonder. Uluru. That's over there. So that's good for some happiness in the empire. And I found a civilization here. It's Poland. Okay, that's a worker. What to build here now? I am going to build here. I'm going for a settler because this isn't the best city location. I really want a better lie, say, on plains or something like that. So... I'm going to build a settler right now, even though I normally wouldn't. And I'm going to get out here. And... okay, that's grassland on a river. That's grassland. That's grassland. Actually, you have 6 turns for masonry, so... I'm going to chop down the forest. That'll give me a production boost on... you know, when it's chopped down. But that's just a placeholder till masonry comes up. I'll interrupt that when masonry comes, and then go ahead and switch to a quarry on the stone. And there's masonry. Now, I'm going to go for calendar. Right, and I said I was going to interrupt that and build a quarry. How long is that going to take? I forgot to look. 23 turns. Well, down at the bottom of the pack for well-fed. Oh well, not a big deal. Let's take a look at the religion thing again. And we don't know the other one that we haven't met this civilization either. So it's possible that one of them is the Celts. Given how early in the game that first religion went, is almost certainly the Celts. Oh, there's a city-state over there. First ones to meet Prague as well. Oh, that's a city-state quest. We might as well go for that now. Of course, we're attacking somebody on a hill, so that's going to be tedious. Well, after that attack, got to let the guy heal. What we want to get to with the scout is survivalism 3, because that once we have that, we're healing 20 points per turn, and we heal even if we don't stand still. Which means that taking 35 damage on a fight and then healing 20 means a net damage of 15. And that is actually helpful for the scouts. Quite helpful, actually. Okay, good. Okay, so we took a massive... Because the guy's fortified on a hill, so that's a pretty difficult one to beat. And we got survivalism 2, so now we're going to heal 20 points per turn. And we'll again let the healing happen. Now, we'll attack again. That's going to take a while. This is generally why you're not attacking your barbarians with a scout, because the scout's not very strong. But scouts are, I think, better at defending than attacking, so... Anyway, moving along, let the scout heal. We'll be able to take this guy. It's all about strategy. You know, like attacking with a scout, you're okay attacking brutes, but you wouldn't want to be attacking spearmen or any of the stronger barbarian units. You could probably get away with taking out a barbarian archer. But that'd be about it. That would be about all I would risk with a scout that doesn't at least have the survivalism 3. Okay, next turn we should be able to clear the camp, the encampment there. There we go. Now Prague is our friend for a bit. I'll let the scout heal. We're gonna have a quarry real soon now. There we go. So that's added one to the production and two faith. And that's exactly what we wanted. And then we'll head over here and do the same thing here. And then we'll have another two faith. And that might make up the deficit that we're fighting against to get first religion. Because we're friends with Prague, we can stroll through their territory. So why not? It's a little more direct that way. Right. More barbarians. Might be worth going after this guy just to get our survivalism 3 promotion. We didn't zone of control. We couldn't just clear the camp, but we'll be able to clear the camp before attacking the barbarians. There we go. We cleared the camp. And see where it heads off to. Oh, we got a policy. Honor increases our strength against barbarians, and we get culture every time we kill one. So I'm actually going to take that one. And it also shows us where the encampments are, which is useful. So I'm going to chase this guy, because he's probably heading for an encampment. Okay. I'm gonna have to let my scout heal here. Oh. This is good. Got survivalism 3 now. So it's gonna heal even while we're chasing the guy. Okay, there's our settler. And now we need to pick where we're going to build a city. Oh, right, I need to pick something to build. I'm going to build a warrior because I need something to protect my settlers and so on. Can't go there, can go there. One, two, three. Oh, this is going to be fun. Not sure where I want to build the city. This would be a good spot because of the wheat resources. And that's the wheat isn't in range of the capital. So I think this is where I should build the city. It's close to the capital, but I think it's the best location. Okay, what's doing down here? Where is... Ooh. I need to run away. Otherwise, Scout's gonna die. What I want to do is recapture that worker there. Okay. Right. What did I say? I really wanted the sailing thing. Animal husbandry will reveal horses. Bronze working is iron and give us this. Writing, give us a great library. Sailing it is. I want to be able to develop these resources. Now, is it worth burning a turn to look over here? I don't think it is, because I want to settle on the river anyway. Okay, and there's the hills in range. Okay, right there. And I'm going to go for a shrine. Oh, right. It's gone for growth. I think that's the right choice there. 15 turns. And there will be a second citizen there. Okay. So I'll kill that guy. 8 culture for killing the barbarian. That's kind of cool. So it's going to take a bit to take that camp there. Oh my, we have a barbarian there. I need to let that guy heal a bit. Oh, the barbarian actually attacked the city. So it is possible for barbarians to control cities if they manage to take one. It actually is possible. Okay. Right. Since I'm out killing barbarians, having grabbed the honor opener will actually give the significant benefit culture-wise. You want to make sure you don't end up with your strength down too far and your attacking units, just in case the encampment spawns another barbarian. That can be just like that, in fact. Right. Okay, I need to move this guy out of the way until that barbarian goes away. Okay. One more turn there for healing. Need to let that guy settle. Okay. Now I need to take out this guy. Okay, so that's a lot better now. So when the warrior finishes here, I'll send him after the encampment there. Okay, we got a promotion. So medic, not so good if you, but now scouting one gives us increased visibility. So I'll make this a much better scout. Okay, so we'll work on the quarry there. That seems reasonable. I don't really care if people know where my capital is. If I was playing against human opponents, I might. Okay, now I have a warrior there. I'm going to try for Stonehenge. Stonehenge is worth it both for the plus 5 faith and the great engineer points. So that makes Stonehenge well worth going for. Okay, that does for that. Ooh, met Sweden. And there is the quarry there. Now I'll go back over there and continue chopping down the forest. What I really want out of my capital is for it to grow. Because if I have too little production there, I can always set up trade routes that are sending production to the capital. But if I don't have enough food to support things. Okay, so we'll go after that camp there. Now, warriors upgrade all the way up to mechanized infantry. So, unlike previous versions of the game, warriors themselves are not totally useless for long-term investments. Spearmen, on the other hand, upgrade to anti-tank guns ultimately, and that's not as useful. Okay. We'll return the unit to Prague. Ooh, ally of Prague. Okay, we got... We're on open terrain. We'll go for shock one. Prague, we're... Okay, we'll be an ally for like two turns. That's not a big deal, but... we'll do that. Again, the... Right, okay. If I'd attacked there, I might have won on the encampment, but then this guy would have attacked and I'd have been done for. So definitely not the situation I would have wanted there, so which is why I just set him up to heal. So you can see the difference. Extended sight radius makes up here. The warrior is I'm gonna leave it there and just see if I do survive. The barbarians often don't attack when they're injured too much, so that wasn't as much of a risk as it looked like. Okay, so we can easily dispatch that. And the encampment. There we go. So that threat has been eliminated there. Now, are there any nearby ones? Okay, anyway. That's a definite improvement in the local landscape there. Oh, I meant to go one by one there. Send the warrior back to my territory. He'll heal faster, given that he's down so far. More barbarians. So let the warrior heal. Maybe I will go for that and see if I can get up to scouting 3. Right, somebody else got a Pantheon. Yep, the Celts are in fact in the game. Okay, we'll go for scouting 2. I'm just going to check here. Religion overview. And yes, the Celts did get the first Pantheon. Okay, so optics allows embarkations. So, animal husbandry or optics? I think animal husbandry would be a good choice. There happened to be a city-state right on my doorstep, and I had no idea because I went the other way. Okay, that archer there should be dealt with real quickly. Right, archer's dealt with now. He'll deal with that archer. Ooh, that might not be a good spot for that scout. So that's what I was talking about earlier. Oftentimes, your scouting units end up getting in a fix where you just stroll into a situation where there's like 10 barbarians and they just take you out. Okay, so I'll go with shock 2. It clears that. Another city-state over there. Cool. Just gonna let that guy heal a bit. Same with that one. What have we got over? Oh, it's a hand axe. Oh, there's the encampment that was targeted. I should send this warrior back around here. Anyway. Can I purchase a workboat? I can. Good. So I want to improve one of these resources here. You know what? Now I'm just gonna wander around over there. That's plus one food. And it's plus one food for both of them. Okay. I'll do the crab then. Okay, what to do here? Well, that's forest, that's grasslands, that's grassland. Okay, that one. Ooh. Okay, there's a barbarian archer up there. Huh, wandered away. Well, I'll start with chopping down that forest. Well, there's another city-state. And more barbarians. Okay. And a policy. Well, if I rush for the Reformation, I can get that right away. Or Liberty would be good for. Yeah, I'm going to go for Liberty here. That increases my culture generation by one per city. And since I am planning a sprawl tactic here, ultimately, that's going to be the best option here. So I'll go after the barbarian there. Anyway, I should probably end this part here since it's up on an hour. I guess that's the end of part one of my Byzantine Civilization 5 game. If you've watched this far, thanks for watching. I'll see you back next time in part two.